As beautiful scenes of Kingsmead Stadium, we are in Durban for the start of a three-match one-day international series between South Africa and Pakistan. It is the home of cricket in KwaZulu-Natal and has been host to over 100 international matches through the years, but this is the very first women's one-day international since readmissions. It was Pakistan who won the toss and they decided to bowl first.
Big appeal, gone! What a start for Pakistan. She has a tendency, Lee, to play around that front leg, and that one just shaping on the line of middle and leg. And a judge to be clattering into the stumps, and that's a perfect start for Pakistan. Shot for four. That is a very, very sweet stroke. That's as much authority as we've seen at any stage from South Africa this morning. Shot through for four. That's the shot of the morning. Bit of width off it, hit it on the up. Exquisite placement. Oh, what a delivery! Having been punished for 10 runs in the early part of the over, Diana Baig has struck back and got through the defensive prod of Sinay Luce. And a second wicket for Pakistan. They're back on top. Nicely clipped, beautifully played off the pads with such ease and grace, and away for four. Oh, beauty! Oh, it's down! It's down! The edge was found. What an over that was from Diana Baig. She's just toiled away outside the off stump, found the edge off that last ball, and the keepers put it down. It's 28 for two from seven.
That's a bit of width and nicely put away. It was airborne. There was an opportunity to be caught and there was a screech of catch it, but the placement was superb by Wolfart. She's been in good touch. Oh, goes for the sweep, and this time she's misjudged the line, the length, and unfortunately it's cost Kodula wicket. She misses it and it clatters into the off stump, and that's the breakthrough Pakistan were after. Here again. Thanks for the quick single. A good pickup. Could be close. Oh, direct hit. I think that's it. That run in there between the wickets has cost South Africa. Wolfart very upset. And Mignon Dupree is pretty disappointed as well. But that was a brilliant bit of fielding. It was a late decision for Wolfart to go through for the single. Mignon Dupree was very interested from the outset. But it was a risk. And it's been through the pressure that's been built by these spinners. It's airborne. And a boundary. And that's a top shot. Just giving yourself a little bit of room. Pops it over the top. Oh, use of the feet. And she tries to go across the line of it. Didn't hold her shape. Trying to hit the leg side. And Sandhu, who's been so impressive, gets that one to just grip turn. And an easy stumping means the fifth wicket for South Africa is down. Oh, that's a bonus wicket. She's picked out the fielder at short mid-wicket. Marazon Kapp is hanging around. She's not too sure whether it was taken cleanly. And we'll have to have a look at the replay. But that was a fantastic effort. And we just don't know if it... if it settled between her legs and whether she managed to grab hold of it after that.
Yeah, I think at that point it definitely touches the ground, Polly.
So the soft signal was out. I think it might have to be overturned. Yes, Brad White, the third umpire, decides not out. And Marazon Kapp was quite justified in standing her ground and making sure it was checked upstairs.
Helped on its way for four. Oh, could be stumped, could be stumped, is stumped. She's given herself out. She set off. It was tossed up and just drifted across outside the off stump. She went for the sweep. Lovely piece of glove work. There's the drag. Oh, she's overbalanced. Can't get back. Neat, quick take. So a timeous wicket for Pakistan will put a bit of a break on the South African scoring with Murray's own cup out. She's gone for 47. It's 171 for 6. That's a good catch. That is a really good catch. She's going to do it herself. Not going to rely on her fielders now. Just chipped back by Nadine de Klerk. And Diana Bay going to follow through, picks up her third wicket. She's been excellent today with ball and in the field. But another South African wicket goes. 172 for 7. De Klerk gone for naught. To the deep, should be taken, is taken. South Africa giving it away here, having been in a decent position, or succumbing to the pressure of runlessness. Trisha Chetty holds out at deep mid wicket. She goes for 7, and it's now 174 for 8. The taller of the left armers is launched over extra cover, and away it goes for 4. Oh, well bowled, kept a nerve. Ismail giving herself room to try and slice it away behind point once again. The young 19-year-old picks up her wicket, knocking back the off stump, and South Africa are 197 for 9. Deceived by the slower ball, unfortunately for South Africa, no addition to that 200 that they've achieved for 9 down. And it's been an innings that never really got momentum. Flattered to deceive somewhat atop the order when Laura Volfart was going well in the company of Laura Goodall. They reached 84 for 2. Then the introduction of spin has resulted in good feeling you can see amongst the Pakistanis, because the spinners bowled beautifully in the middle overs, restricting South Africa from one stage, reducing them from 4.8 to the over down to 3.2 to the over. So South Africa have posted 200, and in this first one-day international here at Hollywoodbets Kingsmead, Pakistan need 201 at just on 4 and over for victory. Yeah! Big appeal and gone. The switch to round the wicket has worked for Shabnam Ismail. A different angle and a better length and line and a little nip away. And the edge is found of Muniba Ali's bat. She's gone for just 1. An early strike from Ismail. Pakistan are 8 for 1. That's poor. That is a poor delivery, and it's going to be 4. Too short. Pulled away. 4 runs. She's been short on a couple of occasions and has been punished on both counts. That's a good stroke to end the over for Pakistan. It's 18 for 1 from 6.
And that's nicely placed. Thinking of the second, Ismail's got a strong arm. This could be tight. Oh, I think she's going to be found wanting. It was a great throw. Is the ball out of the gloves, or is it still in control of the wicketkeeper? Oh, there we go. Out. So the players had all made their way back to their fielding positions, but they quickly sprinting towards Ismail and Chetty to come and celebrate the dismissal, the second one. Edge, and that one's going to be another boundary. Oh, that could be an edge, and it is. So it's just taken her 3 deliveries. And Mlaba has picked up her first international wicket, offered up some flight, the ball purchased in the surface. Good catch by Chetty. And that's brilliant from South Africa.
Cut away, beats the backward point. This will speed away for 4. She's just started to get a little bit too short in her last 2 overs.
Oh, this could be a mistake. If they gather it clearly, as she has, Sikokone has done brilliantly. Absolutely brilliant. They always say, be careful about running on a misfield. And it worked out a trick for South Africa. It was the knock-on, it was a quick recovery from Mignon Dupree, and she threw it to Sikokunu at the bowler's end. And there's the desperation shot, and executed to perfection. A very good shot from Dar. That's a full delivery. Talking about no LBW, she's got one. Sikokunu has got through the defenses of Navaz. was given a bit of air. It looked like it could have been the variation or maybe an off cutter, but it ended up being really full.
Smashed down the ground, straight hit, and all the way. The first of the day, the first of the series. That is a lovely strike.
Wicket, wicket time. Ishmael doing the job once again for a team. Nice and straight. Riaz plays all around it. And the tactic of attacking the stumps works a trick for Ishmael. They pick up the sixth. And she's got back-to-back stumps. Almost an exact repeat of the previous delivery. Lands it in a perfect length. It turns just a touch. Off-cutter delivery and crashes into the stumps. Ishmael Schubert on a hat-trick. Oh, that should be out. I think that's close. Yes. Beats the inside edge again and crashes into the pads.
Smashed into the deep and one bounce for four. In the air and short of mid-off. Nadine de Klerk just failing to get to the ball and Ishmael desperately wanting a fourth wicket. Six from the over. It's 160 for eight. And that's what's resulted. Frustration for Shabnam Ishmael. It's not a pitch to go short. We've seen that today. That's where the boundaries have come from. And that's 50 for Nidadar. What a nice way to get it. There's four. It's an edge down towards third man. Ishmael will chase but give it best. And Pakistan are keeping fighting. Through the covers for four. Wow, I tell you what, this is not done. This is not done. Down the ground it goes. Should be taken. Oh, my word, another one down. Can you credit this? South Africa's out cricket has been appalling in the last five overs. And it will be. It's smashed away over cover and it goes for four. They need just a boundary off the last ball. Can they do it? They believe. Can they do it? Four off the final ball. No, they can't. Wow, South Africa have got out of jail. They will breathe a mighty sigh of relief. What a performance this has been by the visitors and getting this close. My word. What a game we've seen here at Hollywoodbets Kingsmead to open this one-day international season. The South African ladies have got home over their Pakistani counterparts by a meager three runs.